this lecture, we would like to see the PN junction quantitatively. So first, let's discuss about contact potential. Or we can say it as built-in potential. So first, let me draw the diagram for a PN junction. In a PN junction, we know that we have P-type semiconductor in one side and N-type semiconductor on the other side, and this region is known as depletion region or depletion layer or space charge layer, whatever you want to say it. And this is their boundary. If this side is X, then we can say this is 0 or this is at the origin. Let me make it at the middle of this region. So this distance from here to here is, let's say, xn, and this distance from here to here, or this point, we can say minus xp, and this is xp. So now let me draw the energy band diagram for p-type and n-type semiconductor. So this is the energy band diagram for P side. That is, this level is vacuum level, and this is the minimum of the conduction band, that is EC, and this is the maximum of the valence band. And since this is a P-type semiconductor, so Fermi level can be near the valence band. So on other side, so this is P-type semiconductor. So now let's draw the energy band diagram for N-type semiconductor. Similarly, this is vacuum level, this is minimum of the conduction band, that is EC, and this is maximum of the valence band, that is EV. And since this is a N-type semiconductor, so its Fermi level can be somewhere near the conduction band. So this is N-type. When we make a junction from these two semiconductors, we know that electrons will move from where the Fermi level is on the upper height. And so here we can see that the work function of this n-type material is smaller than the work function of the p-type material. So here electrons will move from N side to P side to get equilibrium at the junction. So after making a junction between these two materials, energy bands in the P side will move in the upward direction, since this P side is getting electrons, and the energy bands in the n side will move in downward direction because this side is losing the electrons. So after making a junction, so the energy band diagram will look like this. So this is EV, E vacuum for the P side. This is EC and this is EV. EC and EV. And after making a junction, there is an equilibrium in the Fermi level in both of the sides. So now their energy band diagram will look like this. So there is a bending at the junction like this. So this is E vacuum for N type and this is EC and this is EV for the N type material. So here we can see that there is a potential difference between the minimum of the conduction band or between the vacuum level of these two materials. So this difference is equal to the Q VBI, that is built-in potential. We can call it as a contact potential also. And if we draw the, and we can say this is the Fermi level for n-type material. So I forgot to mention it in this diagram. So this is EFN, that is Fermi level for n-type material, and this is EFP, that is Fermi level for p-type material. And if this is an intrinsic semiconductor, then Fermi level will be between the EC and EV. So this is EFI. So if we draw the intrinsic Fermi level, then we can draw it like this one. So this difference is equal to the EFN minus EFI in N side, and this difference, let me draw it in a different color, and this difference in P side is EF minus EFP. So we can write it as FP, sorry, phi p, which is equal to EF minus EFP. And similarly, we can write it as phi n, which is equal to EFN minus EFI. So here we can see that we have to multiply it by Q. Since I am writing here a phi n as potential, not potential energy. So clearly we can see that here VBI VBI is equal to phi n plus phi p. So to get the value of contact potential, we have to determine the value of this phi n and phi p. So for this, we have to first determine the value of electrons in the conduction band of this n-type, and at the same time we have to determine the value of holes in the valence band of this p-side. So in the n region, the concentration of electron can be written as n naught, which is equal to Nc, and we know what is this Nc. We have already discussed about this in the last unit. So which is equal to Nc exponential minus Ec minus Ef by kT. And I am giving you a very important thing, that why we are dividing this by kT. We always divide this term by kT. What will be happened if we will not divide this function by kT? So you can think about this. So we can also write this equation as n naught, which is equal to ni, and again we have discussed this ni in the last unit. So here we can write it as ni exponential Ef minus Efi by kT. Here Ni is the intrinsic carrier concentration and EFI is the intrinsic Fermi level. And let me write it as equation number first. This is second. This is third. This is fourth. And this is fifth. So from equation first, we can see that EFn minus EFi is nothing but minus Q F phi n, that is from equation 1, from equation 1 we know that EF minus EFI is equal to minus Q phi n. So by putting this value in equation number 5, we can get n naught, which is equal to ni exponential minus q phi n by kt. So this is the equation number 6. And if we take natural logarithm on both sides, we can write this equation as phi n, which is equal to minus kt by q log natural nd by ni. Where I am writing n naught, which is equal to nd, that is number of donor atoms. So this is the equation number 7th, and by using the same relationship we can get number of holes in the valence band of p side, which is equal to na ni exponential efi minus ef by kt. So again, by using the formula EFI minus EF, which is equal to minus Q phi p. So by putting this value in this equation number 8, we can write phi p, which is equal to kt by q log natural na by ni. Let's say this is equation number 9. So we know that phi n plus phi p is nothing but the built-in potential. So by adding equation number 7 and 8, we can get the value of built-in potential, that is kt by q log natural na nd by ni square. So this is the value of contact potential. Contact potential or built-in potential across the junction . So sometime we can use a word that is known as thermal voltage, and we can write this kt by q इक्वल टू थर्मल वोल्टेज और वी टी बाय वी टी विच इज इक्वल टू के टी बाय क्यू. सो समटाइम वी कैन राइट ए टर्म वी टी हियर. सो नाउ लेट्स सी वॉट इज द वैल्यू ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड एट द जंक्शन. And this electric field can be determined by using Poisson equation. And here I am writing the direct value of the electric field, which is equal to E minus Q ND by epsilon naught S x n minus x, where x can vary from 0 to x n. So this is the electric field in the n side. Similarly, we can write the value of electric field in the p side. Similarly, we can get the electric field in the P side. And here one thing is important, that as I discussed in last class, that electric field is maximum at the junction. So here by putting the value of X at zero, we can get maximum E. So here we can get E, that is maximum when X is equal to zero. So we can write it as minus Q and D by epsilon S XN, where epsilon S is the permittivity of the semiconductor or dielectric constant of the semiconductor. And in P side, similarly, we can write minus Q Na by epsilon S into XP. So this is the value of maximum electric field in N side and P side. And from here we can also see that since these two terms are equal, so from here we can write as ND XP, which is equal to NA XN. This is very important relation. Many times we will use this equation for numericals problem. So by using this relation, we can also write built-in potential as VBI, which is equal to Q by 2 epsilon S into ND XN square plus NA XP square, or similar, or we can say this XN is the width in the N region and XP is the width of the depletion layer in the P region. So we can also write built-in potential like this. So now let's see space charge width, space charge width. Or width of the depletion layer, whatever you want to say it. So let's say this is equation number 10. This one is equation number 11. This is equation number 12. This is equation number 13 and this is equation number 14. So from equation number 13, we can write that xp, which is equal to nd xn by na. So we can put this value. Let's say this is equation number 15. So if we put value of xp from equation number 15 to equation number 14, we can get, let me write here, if we put value of xp from equation number 15, equation number 15 to equation number 14, we can get xn, which is equal to two epsilon s VBI by Q into NA by ND into 1 by NA plus ND. And this whole term under the root. So this is the value of xn. In a similar way, we can get the value of xp, that is the width of the depletion layer in the p region. So similarly, we can get xp, which is equal to 2 epsilon s VBI by Q into ND by NA into 1 by ND plus NA, and again this whole term under the root or raised to the power half. So the total depletion or space charge width, we can say it, or we can write it as W, can be written as So W, which is equal to Xn plus Xp. So let's, this is question number 16. And this is the equation number 17. So from 16 and 17, we can write the value of W or space charge width, which is equal to 2 epsilon s VBI by Q into NA plus ND by NA ND and raised to the power half or under the root. So this is the value for space charge width, or this is the width of the depletion layer. So this is equation number 18. And we can also put the value of Xn and Xp in the E maximum, and we can write E maximum as minus Q by epsilon S into 2 epsilon S VBI by Q into NA ND by NA plus ND under the root. So finally, this E maximum will become minus 2 VBI by W. So we can put the, we can rearrange this equation. So here E maximum can be written by using built-in potential and space charge width. So this is equation number 19 and this is equation number 20. So in this lecture we have determined the value of contact potential, electric field and space charge width for a p-n junction. And in the next lecture, we will see the behavior of a p-n junction when we apply various voltage across this junction.